Tyler and I like to fish until we get to 400 salmon.
We only get like a 10-day window to fish because once the ice starts to go in on the shore, you gotta pull the net. That's all of them?
Yeah, I'll count them.
Even though Tyler and I have been doing this 6 years, that doesn't mean we've got everything nailed.
22, 29, males.
We kind of make it up on the fly because there's nobody to ask how to do it.
That's a good start. Yeah, here's some tracks, Ash.
Huh.
There's a bear around. That's the newspaper, you know. You wake up in the morning and walk down your trail, and if there's new tracks and you recognize it, well, then you've got the news. There's somebody in the neighborhood. He'd know for sure about the fish pile because the wind's blowing in his favor. And just our camp is just right over here, less than a quarter mile away, so I'm sure he would know about that too.
Gwen's got a fish head.
Nine of them, huh?
Eight, nine, yep. It's definitely a bear. They know how to pick the spine clean like that.
Yeah. I mean, there's plenty of our scent all over this stuff, so. It knew it was stealing. It's gonna come back to a place where we're coming every day, which is kind of dangerous, you know? We've never had a bear get into our fish pile before, but it sucks to lose fish, you know, because we really need them. Knowing bears and bear behavior, it'll probably be back. It's found out that it can get a free meal here and didn't have any consequences for it. We need to go on the offensive against this guy.
The very hardest thing about living out here is bears.
Bye, I love you.
See ya, love you.
This isn't the Kenai Peninsula, where the bears have seen lots of people. These bears are different up here. They're brave. I mean, human beings just don't, we don't have predators very, you know, like most people don't know what it's like to encounter a real life predator.
Bye, love you.
Love you.
It's scary.
Looking for Indian potato. Interior people call them Indian potatoes. All the root system is right there. I'm picking them to cook them for dinner tonight. Like, you go to the store and get your potatoes. I go out to the gravel bar and get my potatoes.
A
Haimo comes home by 4 o'clock, and 4:30, he'll be eating. I know what he likes and what he doesn't like after being married in so long. He likes to eat lots. It's very important for us to have moose for the winter because we use a lot of meat out here. I'm hoping he'd come home and bring a big moose that is fat.
Without meat, we'd have a very hard time through the winter. It's probably 60% of our diet, maybe more.
This is perfect habitat. You got water, you got willows, you got the timber in here. These are rose hips. This is the same stuff that they buy in health food stores, vitamin C pills. And here it grows wild. That's delicious. And they stay out all winter long. That you can eat these because they're power packed in vitamin C. One time I ate lots of rose hips because I didn't have much food. I was sitting in the outhouse all the time. It was bad. I mean, it was bad. So you got to control your intake. You know, it's too much vitamin C.
You got pumpkin to make a pie? Thanksgiving is, that's probably our favorite holiday.
Well, if we don't get enough grouse, then we could probably have a rabbit.
Mm-hmm. We're thankful just every day. I mean, once you're in the woods, you're relaxed, and you're just thankful to be, you know, be alive and be on your own. All right, well, I'm gonna get busy.
These ones are both mine.
You guys ready?
Mm-hmm.
Throw that bait in that bag.
I'm not a trapper. Ray's the trapper. Ray's very knowledgeable, and he's passing down his knowledge to the girls. I grew up in kind of outskirts of a town, so you know, went to store and bought our meat and whatnot. But you're living out in the woods. You take the game, or you take the meat that you need to sustain yourself. It's a survivalness that kicks in, and the girls, that's how they've grown up.
Yeah. There. The girls, they've always enjoyed being in the woods. It's hard to say how pleased it makes a guy to see their, see how much they enjoy it. They provide a lot of the food and fur with their trap lines. So, yeah, they're ready to fill in my shoes. Good luck.
Back right here. We're really excited to come back out here. It's all we talk about all summer, and now that winter's here, we're like, yeah, let's go. So we are just heading out for the first time for the season. I'm gonna set some traps and some snares.
I think my favorite thing about being out on the line is just being with my sisters, doing what we love.
Now that we're older, it feels really good to be able to contribute to living out here. I guess it's kind of the mentality, if you don't work, you don't eat.
Somebody can take the point right here, kind of over there, and then over there. And then make sure to try the snares Daddy made.
Okay.
Since we didn't get a moose this year, our primary concern is just to get as much meat as we can.